Always low, low prices at Pahrump Valley Auto Plaza.
So, first of all, Scotty did not own Scotty's Castle. Scotty was a con man. Scotty claimed that he had a secret gold mine out in the scariest place in the United States, Death Valley. You're not tough enough to go there. He's tough enough to go out there. So his con was that he got rich investors, mostly from back east, to send him money for him to buy supplies to start mining gold, and then he was supposed to ship them gold. And he did this with several investors, and always had many excuses why it never worked out. Flash flood washed away the mining equipment, heat wave killed the mules, things like that that people might believe about Death Valley. And then one of his investors, a man named Albert Johnson, who was a businessman from Chicago, he came out here to inspect the gold mine. And Scotty had to find some new way to scare him off. So he staged a gunfight, hired his brother and his friends to pretend to be bandits. And in this gunfight, Scotty's brother actually got shot in the hip. And that's when Scotty had to admit that it was a lie. He yelled up at his friends who were the pretend bandits, "Stop shooting, you fools! You just shot my brother!" And so Albert Johnson, by that point, which is 1906, he realized that there was no gold mine. But here's where the story gets weird. He kept investing in Scotty's gold mine that he knew didn't exist. He came out here every year or two from Chicago, so that's a long trip, and would spend a month out here camping in the desert with Scotty. Eventually, Albert Johnson started to bring his wife, Bessie Johnson. She also loved the desert, loved Scotty's stories, but she got tired of camping. Yeah. And that's why they started building the castle in 1922. It took 9 years to build Scotty's Castle, 1922 to 1931. Part of the reason it took so long is once they were partly done, they'd change their mind and say, oh, it would be so much more fun and so much more grand if we did this extra thing. Maybe we should put two stories. Maybe we should put a bridge between them. Maybe we should make it look like a Spanish hacienda when it looked like a shoebox before that. Oh, and maybe it would be fun to have tunnels and a swimming pool and a basement. So they did all those that underground work after the buildings were already here. It's a very odd friendship on the face of it. You take Albert and Bessie Johnson, who were rich and devout Christians, and then they become best friends with a con man.
Yeah.
But part of that story is about opposites, and part of that story also has to do with Albert Johnson's poor health. So before Albert Johnson met Scotty, Johnson had been in a bad train accident that had broken his back, partially paralyzed him, took him about 4 months to learn to walk again, and he had lifelong health issues after that. The doctors predicted when he was about 25 that he would not live past the age of 40, but he lived to be 76. And his wife, Bessie, said that in a letter to her friend, she said, "I attribute my husband Al's good health and long life to two things, Death Valley and Death Valley Scotty." Because, and if you unpack that, that's about the beauty and the peace of being here. And he was a businessman from Chicago. This is a place to relax. Yeah. We all know stress is bad for one's health. And then laughter is the best antidote at all for stress. And that's what Scotty was great at. He was an entertainer who had worked for about 10 years for Buffalo Bill Cody in the Wild West show. The castle was built as a private vacation home for Albert and Bessie Johnson. But Scotty took credit for it. Anytime someone would come by, he would say it was his castle, that he built it on top of his gold mine to keep it secure. And so what started happening is that reporters would come out and they would hear noise under their feet, either inside the castle or out here in the grounds, and they would hunt down Scotty and say, "What is that?" And he would say, "Oh, those are my workers mining gold. Don't tell anyone I built my castle on top of it." But what is a reporter going to say? But of course they're going to say that. Yeah. And so this got into papers across the country, and then people started realizing that maybe there was something interesting to see in Death Valley. Mm-hmm. So part of the main draw for early tourists to come to Death Valley was because of Scotty's castle. Mm-hmm. And the Johnsons started seeing a business opportunity. People saying, "Can we just take a peek around inside for $1.10?
Yeah, yeah.
In the Depression, they were charging $1.10 for a tour of the castle. You could rent a room from them for between $12 and $25 per night, and you could purchase gasoline from them, which I'm sure people really appreciated out here in the middle of nowhere. So one of the intriguing parts of the history here is that the site was never finished. So what you see is as far as they got in construction. Instead, some things like the swimming pool were left unfinished. There's no bottom even on the swimming pool. They didn't get to that. And the reason behind it has to do with a land dispute with the federal government. So in 1931, federal surveyors came out here and told Albert Johnson that he had built his entire $2 million castle on government land that was about to become part of a national park. They said the land he owned was actually a mile northwest of here, where there was no castle, just desert hills, and even more critically, no water source. And so at that point, Albert Johnson stopped construction. There was a six-year halt from 1931 to 1937 until he got a law passed by Congress that gave only two men the right to buy this property back from the National Park Service, which was either Walter Scott, Death Valley Scotty, or Albert Johnson. For the next couple years, until the castle is fully back open to the public, the only way to see Scotty's Castle is with the flood recovery tour. You can find out about that and make a reservation, which is required, at the website dvnha.org, which is the website of our nonprofit partner, Death Valley Natural History Association. They're also accepting donations to help out with the flood recovery.